afternoon, everyone. I have a breaking update with regards to We Build the Wall. A loyal subscriber just got through sending me this link. It is a statement that says that the city says that private border wall didn't have a building permit and orders construction to cease and desist. This was just put up at 4:10 Eastern time today. There's a little video that goes along with it that I'm going to try to get to play for you guys. I'm having some internet issues right now. But I'm going to go ahead and read as much of this as I can get away with here. City officials in Sunland Park, New Mexico, have delivered a cease and desist order to the owners of land where a private border wall is being built. The project doesn't have proper permits to proceed because an application filed was incomplete, Sunland Park spokesman Peter Abrero told CNN. The rules apply to everyone, Abrero says. That's the process. The incomplete application isn't the only issue, Sunland Park Mayor Javier Perez told reporters Tuesday. My understanding is that city ordinance only allows a wall up to 6 feet tall, and this far exceeds that, he said, which we know that it does because Brian said that it was 18 feet, I believe. The city's chief inspector is scheduled to visit the site Wednesday to help determine the next steps, Abrero said. The group says the city has political motivation. Brian Colfidge, whose GoFundMe campaign raised more than $20 million to build the wall on private property, disputed the city's assessment, describing the cease and desist order as political intimidation. Construction on that site halted Tuesday after the order was received, Colfidge says. Attorneys for his group, We Build the Wall, met with city officials about permits Tuesday evening, subsequently submitted a revised site plan, he said. What we really think is, we think it's a political issue. People are raising a fit about this. People don't like that it's happening, Colfidge said. That's why we waited as long as we did to file the paperwork. And there is a picture for you. We Build the Wall founder Brian Colfidge released the photo. He said shows work has paused at the site. Chris Colfidge, general counsel for We Build the Wall, said in a statement that building development and rock wall permits had been filed and that city inspectors had given the project a green light before Memorial Day weekend. We were then instructed by the same city officials that we were good to proceed the construction with construction over the holiday weekend and that we would not have any issues being shut down, Colfidge said. The city manager, we don't selectively enforce the law, he says. Sunland Park city manager Julia Brown told CNN that the city's cease and desist order has nothing to do with politics. There's no political motivation on the part of the city, simply our interest in having our code and ordinances complied with, she said. This applicant is not being treated any differently from any other applicant in that all applicants are expected to comply with the law. We don't selectively enforce the law, do not show favoritism, or ignore our own laws. Founder states that they raised $600,000 in a few hours, which is true. We were watching it. We know that at the time that I did my video yesterday, that there was another $500,000 that had been raised just based on the fact that these pictures were available for people to see. I'm going to go back up here. You guys can read the rest of this on your own. I am going to take a look here and see if I can get this to stream for you guys so that you can see the little video that's on here. Okay, this little video does not want to stream the way that I'd like for it to. So what I'm going to do is stream it out separately for you and go ahead and edit it onto the back of this video, and I will and that will hopefully allow you guys to see it. I will link this article in the description below this video, just keeping you updated on what's going on with We Build the Wall. Take care, everyone.
President Trump's border wall plan was just shot down by a federal judge. So one group says they're going to take matters into their own hands. They've been crowdfunding and gathering millions and millions of dollars to build a border wall with Mexico. And they have broken ground.
I have talked to the president in the last few weeks about this very construction site and told him all about it. He's very much in favor of it. And I've spoken to the president prior to that about We Build the Wall and the effort of private citizens to build border structures. And he's been very much in favor of it.
So let's go live now to CNN's Nick Valencia with more on this. Nick, thanks so much. So who's running this move and how much have they raised?
Well, you heard there from Chris Kobach. He's one of the very prominent conservative names attached to this project. But the funding, the money was all crowdfunding. As you mentioned, Lynn, $20 million on a GoFundMe account started by a guy named Brian Kolfage. He is who I spoke to earlier today. And he says that they are building the wall because the politicians in Washington can't get enough done. He knows that the wall is controversial. And he says, though, that they've been given the blessing by the Department of Homeland Security, if you can believe it.
Getting done. And we're not trying to build the entire southern border wall. This is protest wall. The president supports it. DHS supports it. So we've had the blessing of our government to move forward with this project.
And things are moving quite quickly, Lynn. You see video that our CNN crew shot just yesterday. The organization behind this is called We Build the Wall. They're partnering with a construction firm called Fisher Sand and Gravel. They're the ones that actually came up with the design. So it was earlier this year that the government put forward a request for proposal for companies who said that they can build the wall. Fisher Sand and Gravel is one of those companies. They say they actually do it even better than the government in that the steel they use lasts for 75 years rather than around 35, which is what typically is the steel used right now on parts of the wall along the southern border. They also say they give technology, so there's a seismic reader in case someone tries to dig a tunnel underneath. They are standing behind this very controversial project.